Arya.
Honored to meet you. What's your name?
Shishi. Okay. He's like, it's such an honor to meet you. What's your name, by the way?
Yeah.
I love it. So I saw the entire cast posing for photos on the red carpet. It seems like everyone got to know each other pretty well and became like a tight little family.
It was important that we shot the movie on location and didn't like do it in New York or LA. We shot in Ocean City, Maryland, where I grew up going on vacation.
Yeah.
And we shot in the fall. So it was like Indian summer, great weather, and you're isolated in a way that just makes you, a film production makes you bond anyway, but when you're on location, I think it's immeasurable. And typically a production isn't allowed to do that because of production and union and money, but I stuck to my guns, and that's why everyone feels, it feels like a camp reunion right now.
Definitely, yeah. And you brought so many fresh faces on board too, right? Like these girls were just telling us that it's their first time doing a movie ever. That's great.
That was important to me as well. It's like, you know, that it's the catch 22. I've been trying to make this movie for 22 years, and today's the premiere. That's bizarre to think about, but it's like, it's the catch 22 in acting is like, how do you get the break? If you only get the job if you're already there.
Right.
And I really.
Which is exactly how Hollywood works sometimes, let's be honest.
It's how the world works, but Hollywood especially. So I really wanted to find kids from the Maryland area who felt real, like real kids, not these caricatures of child roles and actors.
Okay.
So they're really actors, they're great, but they're just, they didn't have the experience that another production might have said.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have a resume. We can't hire them. And I was looking for those types of people specifically.
That's good. It's more natural that way, too. So what were some of the things that you taught them about the 80s?
Maybe, you know, it's funny. I was trying not to be as specific. It was more the lingo. I really didn't want to burden them with that because they were nervous about we were shooting on film. They hadn't acted before. So I didn't want to put pressure on them to be like, how would I act if I was in the 80s? It's like the kids are the same. The wardrobe, the hair, and the lingo took care of making them in the 80s.
Okay, what about some of the key words from pop culture back in the 80s?
Well, like crazy fly is a word that's in the movie.
Okay.
The character says def, D-E-F. That was like a word before like fresh.
Oh.
But like to say def, now everyone says dope or swag or whatever.
Yeah,
so it's a matter of just changing their language a little bit and then they were fine.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. And I feel like every single one of us can relate to Rad in a certain way. What about you personally? Did you experience any growing pains when you were growing up?
I mean, I was Rad.
Okay.
I didn't have the like the narrative stuff that happens in the movie, but I grew up going on vacation with my family. I loved hip hop. I loved ping pong. I went to that mall. The character in the mall goes and buys a rap tape. That's the tape I bought in 1986. The movie's set in 85, so there's a little bit of leeway there. But I'm that kid.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm Chinese, which means I am a champion at ping pong. So if I were to play against you, who would win?
If I was in the zone, I might beat you. If my head got in the way, which happens 80% of the time, you would destroy me.
Really?
I'm confident. You would beat me. And I'm not just saying that to be nice.
Anyway, watching some of the scenes from the movie, it's almost kind of nostalgic in a way because, like, for example, the fishing pier was completely destroyed by Hurricane Sandy.
A day and a half after.
What was that like? What's it like for you guys to, you know, go back and watch the movie and know that some of the locations are not there anymore?
It's just, like I said, this movie has been in my head for 22 years, so the fact that there was a epic hurricane hitting the day after we wrapped, it just felt, not to be like self-absorbed, but it felt kind of biblical, the timing of it, that we got the movie wrapped by then. So for me, it was just trying to tap into, as a filmmaker, every movie is a different challenge, and I wanted to tap into, can I tell a movie from a 13-year-old's innocent perspective in 1985 and get my 2014, 39-year-old face out of the way.
Yeah.
So trying to stay as innocent and respectful of that voice and that era. And that was the challenge. And that's up for everyone else to decide if we did that or not.